Welcome to Maths class for Standard 8. Today, we will be discussing the subtopic Operations on Rational Numbers. This subtopic is also included in Maths for Class 7. Let us begin with the first operation on rational numbers, which is addition. While adding rational numbers with the same denominators, we need to follow some rules. Now let's take the example of two rational numbers, 7 upon 3 and minus 5 upon 3. These rational numbers have same denominators. So when the denominators are the same, we add only the numerators and we take a common denominator. So let's proceed. We begin with adding these rational numbers. So we write 7 upon 3 plus minus 5 upon 3. Taking the common denominator and writing the numerators, 7 plus minus 5, we get 2 upon the common denominator, 3. This is the second case wherein we can add rational numbers where the denominators are different. So let's take two rational numbers, 4 upon 3 and 3 upon 6. Now these denominators are not the same. They are different. When denominators are not the same, we need to take the LCM of the denominators. So taking the LCM of 3 and 6, we get LCM 6. So now let's proceed with the addition. The given rational numbers are 4 upon 3 and 3 upon 6. Performing addition on these rational numbers, and since we have taken the LCM, we will write the first rational number, which is 4 upon 3, multiplied by 2 in the numerator and 2 in the denominator. The reason why we have done this is we have 3 here in the denominator, and since the LCM was 6, we need to multiply 3 by such a number that we are going to get 6. So 3 multiplied by 2, and since we've taken 2 in the denominator, we are going to multiply the numerator with the same number. Addition, 3 upon 6. Now 6 is already here. The LCM is 6. So what number will we have to multiply by 6 to get 6? We need to multiply it with 1. And then any number multiplied by 1 gives us the number itself. The next step, we will multiply. 4 multiplied by 2 is 8. And 3 multiplied by 1 is 3. Now if you look here, the denominators have become the same. 3 multiplied by 2 is 6 and 6 multiplied by 1 is 6. So we are going to take the common denominator here. So I'll say it again. We've got 8, which is 4 multiplied by 2, and 3 in the numerator. And we've taken the common denominator. Adding the numerators, we get 11 upon 6. Subtraction of rational numbers. We need to perform subtraction of rational numbers when the denominators are the same. So let us take example of two rational numbers, which is 5 upon 6 and 2 upon 6. We will proceed the same way as we had while doing addition of rational numbers with same denominators. When denominators are the same, we take the common denominator and we perform the operation only on the numerators. So taking the common denominator 6, we subtract 5 minus 2. Proceeding further, we'll get 5 minus 2 is 3 upon the common denominator 6. Now this rational number can further be reduced using 3 times table. So we get 3 ones are and 3 twos are. So, we get 1 upon 2. The second case is when we need to subtract rational numbers with different denominators. So let's take the example of two rational numbers, minus 3 upon 4 and 5 upon 6. Since the denominators are different, we need to take the LCM of the denominators. Taking the LCM of 4 and 6, we get 12. So we now need to take the first rational number, 3 upon 4, and we need to multiply the denominator by the number which is going to give us 12. So we have multiplied 4 by 3, and since we have multiplied the denominator by 3, we are going to multiply the numerator also by 3. So we've got a new rational number now, which is minus 9 upon 12. We'll do the same thing with the next rational number. We have multiplied the denominator by 2 so that we get 12, which is the LCM. And since we have multiplied the denominator with 2, we are also going to multiply the numerator with 2. So the new rational number we have got is 10 upon 12. So performing subtraction on the given rational numbers, minus 3 upon 4 and 5 upon 6, we get minus 9 upon 12 and minus 10 upon 12. Now the denominators are the same. So since denominators are the same, we will take the common denominator and perform subtraction only on the numerators. So minus 9 minus 10 gives us minus 19. So minus 19 upon 12 is the new rational number. Multiplication of rational numbers. While multiplying the given rational numbers, we need to multiply the numerators and we need to multiply the denominators. Very simply stated, the multiplication of rational numbers is equal to the product of the numerators and the product of denominators. So let us take the example of two rational numbers, 5 upon 4 and 10 upon 5. By multiplying the numerators together and multiplying the denominators together, we get 5 multiplied by 10, which are the numerators, and 4 multiplied by 5, which are the denominators. So 5 multiplied by 10 is 50, and 4 multiplied by 5 is 20. Reducing this further, we get 5 upon 2. Division of rational numbers. For carrying out division on rational numbers, we have to multiply the first rational number with the reciprocal or inverse of the second rational number. So let us take two rational numbers, 1 upon 4 and 5 upon 4. Performing division on these rational numbers, we will write 1 upon 4 divided by 5 upon 4. The rule is that we take the reciprocal of the second rational number. So by taking the reciprocal of the second rational number, we get 1 upon 4 multiplied by 4 upon 5. So we have inversed it now. Now we will perform multiplication. We multiply the numerators, 1 multiplied by 4, and we multiply the denominators, 4 multiplied by 5, which gives us 4 upon 20. On further reducing this, we get 1 upon 5. You may perform the stated operation on the rational numbers and complete the exercise on your notebooks. Hopefully, the video will have cleared any queries that you might have had. Like, subscribe and share, and don't forget to give a thumbs up in the comments below. Thank you.